We want to evaluate the given definite integral. To do this, we'll first find the antiderivative function using the Powell rule of integration given here, and then we'll determine the value of the definite integral using the fundamental theorem of calculus stated here, where if big F of x is the antiderivative function, then big F of b, where b is the upper limit of integration, minus big F of a, where a is the lower limit of integration, is equal to the definite integral. But before we apply the Powell rule of integration, we will have to manipulate this function so each term is in the form of x raised to the power of n. So let's start by writing this as the integral from 1 to 3 of 4x squared plus 5 divided by x to the 1/2 power. And now we'll divide each term in the numerator by x to the 1/2. So we'd have 4x squared divided by x to the power of 1/2 plus 5 divided by x to the power of 1/2. So now in this first term, since we're dividing and the bases are the same, we would subtract the exponents on x. So we'd have 4x to the power of 2 minus 1/2. That's the same as 4/2 minus 1/2, or 3/2. And then for the second term, if we move this x to the 1/2 up to the numerator, it's going to change the sign of the exponent. So we can write this as 5x to the power of negative 1/2. And now we can apply the Powell rule of integration. The antiderivative of 4x to the power of 3/2 would be 4 times x to the power of 3/2 plus 1, that's going to be 5/2, divided by 5/2, and then plus the antiderivative of 5x to the power of negative 1/2 would be 5 times x to the power of negative 1/2 plus 1, that's positive 1/2, divided by 1/2. We need to evaluate this at the upper and lower limits of integration, but before we do this, let's simplify. Dividing by 5/2 is the same as multiplying by 2/5. So we can write this as 4 over 1 times 2/5 x to the power of 5/2, and then plus 5 dividing by 1/2 is the same as multiplying by 2 over 1, or just 2, x to the 1/2. And here we're going to have 8/5 x to the 5/2 power plus 10 x to the 1/2 power. And now we'll evaluate this at 3 and 1. So we'll have some quantity when x is 3 minus some quantity when x is 1. Notice when x is 3, we would have 8/5 3 to the 5/2 power plus 10 times 3 to the 1/2 power minus, now we'll substitute 1 for x, so we'll have 8/5 1 to the 5/2 plus 10 times 1 to the 1/2 power. Notice the exponents on 3 are not the same, so we can't add these. So let's go ahead and write this as 8/5 times 3 to the 5/2 power plus 10 times 3 to the 1/2 power. But notice how here, 1 raised to the 5/2 and 1 raised to the 1/2 would be 1. So we have minus the quantity 8/5 plus 10, or 10 over 1. So we obtain a common denominator of 5. We can combine these two terms. So let's write this as 8/5 times 3 to the 5/2 power plus 10 times 3 to the 1/2 power. And this would be minus 8/5 plus 50/5. That would be minus 58/5. So I would probably stop here and leave the value in this form. But in some textbooks, they may simplify further. So just in case you're curious, let's simplify this some more. Let's go ahead and factor 3 to the 1/2 power out of just the first two terms. This would leave us with 8/5 times 3 to the second. Notice 3 to the second times 3 to the 1/2 is 3 to the 5/2. Then we'd have plus 10 Factoring out 3 to the 1 half would just leave 1, so we can leave that off, minus 58 fifths. Notice now we can simplify the expression here inside the parentheses. We would have 3 to the 1 half, and then we'd have 9 times 8 fifths, which would be 72 fifths, and then plus 10, or 10 over 1, and then minus 58 fifths. Obtaining a common denominator here, we'd multiply by 5 over 5. So we can write this as 3 to the 1 half times the quantity 52 fifths plus 50 fifths. That would be 122 fifths minus 58 fifths. So we could also express the exact value of the definite integral in this form, or 3 to the 1 half is the same as the square root of 3. So we could write this as 122 square root 3 divided by 5 minus 58 fifths if we wanted to. So I don't see a real reason for going this far, but just so you know, the value could also be expressed in either of these two forms here. I hope you found this explanation helpful.